Initially, every Emyoga circle received 30 million shillings at the constituency level, but during a performance evaluation meeting for Hoima Zono area that is comprised of 10 districts held at Hotel Contique in Hoima City, it was found that the progress of a number of groups in the districts neighboring the Rift Valley were badly affected by floods. In Bulisa alone, 480 Emyoga associations are no longer functioning because most of them belonged to fishermen and fishmongers, where landing sites are completely submerged.
My call to the government that they should look into strategically affirmative action of those affected Emyoga circles across the landing sites, not only for Bulisa, but for the old Bunyoro road, or even Lake Victoria was also affected. So across the fisher groups should look into it, and then we see the way forward.
Fishing business was the main source of income for members in Kagadi and Bulisa. Authorities report even a government fish processing facility worth 700 million shillings that was set in Daiga sub-county in Kagadi district for fish value addition was also submerged.
We had a program by government of value addition. Fish, because they were going to put a fish processing plant, but the whole of it, about 40 feet, the building was capsized in water. So you can see. And then the people there definitely had issues of now food and so on. But the government came in from Prime Minister's office and they gave us some relief.
It's on this note that the Microfinance Support Center has promised to allocate additional 20 million shillings seed capital to members of the affected circles to help them recover.
The Microfinance Support Center is going to advance them loans at an interest rate of 8% a year, and we shall continue supporting them to see them come out of poverty.
Masika attributes some of the program inefficiencies to lack of technical knowledge. High interest rates also remain a challenge for members seeking to start business using loans.
Realized that people are just being excited about accessing money from a Emyoga program simply because they want to touch the money. But again, the money is not helping them.
Floods around Lake Albert Shores started in March 2020 and left hundreds of people displaced in several districts. This report was compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba for the news.